Hello students, this is the video for class 11 student and this is the fourth video on the topic of number system. Now in this video we are going to discuss about decimal number system, but before going to the details of decimal number system, let me just give a quick revision of the previous video, then after we'll start with the decimal number system. Now if you have not gone through the previous video, I will request you to please see the last video so that you will understand what is number system and the binary number system very well. So what is number system? Number system is basically a system in which we can represent a number in different way. So we have discussed only four basic number system, which are binary number system, decimal number system, octal number system and hexadecimal number system. Now what is binary number system? It accepts only 0 and 1. What is decimal number system? It accepts 1 to 9. What is hexadecimal number system? It accepts 0 to 16. And what is octal? It accepts 0 to 7. That I have already discussed in the previous video. Now here we are going to discuss about decimal number system. Now decimal number system accepts 0 to 9. So the base of decimal number system is 10. 0 to 9. So the base of the decimal number system is 10. Now conversion. As we have already discussed that we can convert a number from one base to the another. So I can convert a decimal number to its equivalent binary number. I can convert a decimal number to its equivalent octal number or to its equivalent hexadecimal number too. So if a number is given in decimal number system, how can we convert it to a equivalent binary number? So what I am going to do, I am going to divide the number by 2. Whatever be the result is, I'll store the number. Whatever be the remainder is, I'm going to store the remainder. So here, and I'll continue this process till I'll get a number which is lesser than 2. So here it is 16. I have divided 16 by 2. So I got 8 and the remainder is 0. So I'll store 0 separately. Now I'll divide 8 by 2, I'll get 4 as result and 0 will be the remainder. I'll store 0 separately. Then again I'll divide 4 by 2 and I will get 0 as remainder. Again it is 2, I'll divide 2 by 2 and I'll get remainder 0. Now here it is the result, and here A1 is the result when I have divided 2 by 2. So 1 is lesser than 2. I can't divide 1 by 2 as it is lesser than 2. So I'll keep the number like this. So then after I'll write it from bottom to up order. So I'll write it like 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. Clear? I'll write it from bottom to up order. I'll write it like 1, 4, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So let me discuss it once again with another example. Say the number is 33 in the base 10. So how can I convert it to a binary number? So I will divide the number by 2. So if I divide 33 by 2, I'll get 16 as result and 1 will be the remainder. Again I'll divide 16 by 2, I'll get 8 as result and 0 will be the remainder. I'll divide 8 by 2, I'll get 4 as result and 0 will be the remainder. Likewise, if I divide 4 with 2, I'll get 2 as result and 0 as remainder. Again, I'll divide 2 by 2, I'll get 0 as remainder and 1 as result. So, 1 is lesser than 2. I can't divide 1 further. So, I'll keep it like this. And then after I'll write it from bottom to up order as I have told just right now. So, it will be 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. And the base will be 2. Now see, if the number is in point, so it is 63.15, what I will do over there? So in that case, the left hand side of the point, I will do the same whatever I did just right now. I will divide the number by 2, I will keep the remainder stored. Then what I will do with the right hand side of the point? In that case, right hand side of the point, I will multiply it with 2, I will take the part which is at the left hand side of the point and I'll again multiply the left hand right hand side of the point with 2. Let me tell it to you once again. So the right hand side of the number is 0.15. I will multiply it with 2. So the result will be 0.30. I will take 0 as it is the right left hand side of the point and I'll keep 0.30. I will multiply it with again 2. I will get 0.60. I will take 0. I'll keep 0.60 and multiply it with 2. I'll get 1.20. I'll take 1. I'll keep 0.20 and I'll multiply it with 2 and I'll continue till 4 decimal or 5 decimal point. Am I clear? So what I have to do, I have to take the right hand side of the point, I have to multiply it with 2, and from the result I'll take the left hand side only. I'll keep the right hand side intact and again I'll multiply that right hand side with 2. Again I'll take the left hand side only and I'll keep the right hand side intact and again I'll multiply it with 2. Like that way I'll continue till 4 to 5 decimal point. So the 63.5, as I have already calculated the left right hand side of the point over here, so it will be 0010. It will be 0010. I will take the order like this, and the left hand side of the point, which is 63, I'll do the same thing, and then I have got one total 61. I have got, so I have written it total 61.0010 base 2. I think it is clear to you all. Now, how can I convert our decimal number to its equivalent octal number? In case of decimal to any conversion, what I have to do? I have to divide the number by the base where I want to convert. So, in where I want to convert it from decimal to binary, I have divided it by using 2. Here, I want to convert it to decimal to octal, I will divide it by 8. So whatever be the result, remainder will be, I'll keep it and I will write it in the bottom of order, and that will be your octal number. Same way, same thing I have to do what I have did in the previous, where I have converted a number from decimal to binary. In case of decimal to octal, I have to do the same thing, only here I have to divide the number by using 8, as the base of octal number is 8. So when I want to divide the, when I want to convert a number from decimal to hexadecimal, the same thing I have to do, I have to divide the number, but in here I have to apply 16 instead of 2 or 8. Why? Because the base of hexadecimal number is 16. So whatever remainder I will get, I will store it and I will again convert it, and that will be your hexadecimal number. Here it is 2FA. I think it is clear to you all, and this is the end of decimal to binary, decimal to octal and decimal to hexadecimal conversion. So the next part of the video, that octal to other number system conversion and hexadecimal to other number system conversion, will discuss in the upcoming video. Now thank you for watching the video. Please, if you have any confusion, please write in the comment box so that I can go through the comment and I can answer your question too. Thank you for watching. Be safe. Stay at home.